1214年2月のロシアによるクリミア併合に端を発する、いわゆるウクライナ危機は、冷戦後の欧州のみならず、アジア太平洋を含む国際秩序全体に少なからぬ影響を及ぼしています。
Russian aggression certainly was exploring certain problems which Ukraine has had at this moment. This is related to the corruption in state institutions and weak institutions, unfortunately. This is changing these days, but it's still a long way to go on this issue.
クリミアの帰属変更に関しまして、ロシアは住民投票による住民の明確な意思とか、自決権というものを強調して、コソボの例を引き合いに出しております。
So, whatever Russia's foreign governments might have said, we always wanted to have deep, strong relations with the European Union. We wanted to be part of Europe.
There's increasing personalization of power. More and more system in Russia is not a collective Putin as it was once called, but it's the one person, Putin. We do see changes in the institutional power structure. We see a militarization of society, as far as I can tell. If you watch Russian television, this becomes very clear.
The U.S. has also wanted to impose some costs on Russia for what it's done.Both in the hopes that it would change Russian behavior, a hope which I think was clearly has not been realized, but even short of that, to send a political message both to Moscow about Western unity and cohesion. So this, preserving the sanctions and preserving EU and US collaboration on sanctions has been a major priority for those two reasons.
But I don't see any parallel or linkage between the Crimea crisis and what was happening in South Sentinel. Reclamation of the seven small islands at the same time. So just, I think that was just one coincidence.With the Crimean crisis.
Crimea used to be a part of the Ukraine and now become a part of the Xinjiang Russia. But Taiwan and Xinjiang Tibet has been part of China. China has a strong claim to the no country in the world claim Taiwan, Tibet, Xinjiang part of that country. So that's difficult issue. I think the major difference between the independent movement of Taiwan compared with the Ukraine crisis.
日ロ関係についてトランプ現象がどういうふうにこう動いていくか、インパクトがあるのかというと、おそらく選挙公約とかいろんなことを守るとすれば、トランプさんはオバマさんと違って、あまりこう日ロの責任に介入しない、反対しないのかなというふうに見てまして、もしそうであれば、日本にとって領土交渉等がやりやすくなります。
Whether they're ethnic German, Jewish, or whatever from the former Soviet Union, they are a largely Russian-speaking population.
Yeah. What they can implement, for instance, I don't know why is a problem for you to close the border with Ukraine?
西とロシアとの関係というものはですね、近く変わることはないという発言、これは正しいと思うんです。
So Russia wants just to to set the kind of Soviet Union again. Of course, the Russian factor was the factor in the elections. But please, do understand, I personally believe in the wisdom of the American people.
むしろ中国は北にも目を向けているとこういう関係ですね。それでこの再挑戦はウクライナから買ったものですね。
で、EU に行ったりですね、東南アジアどうも回ったり、中アジアを回るとですね、日本がある国をどうもこう意識して、外交を展開し続けるのではないか、結構、評判があまり良くないですよね。 なぜかというと、どの国もそんな日本とその国のとですね、対立なんかに巻き込まれたくないわけですけど、それぞれの国は東南アジアのものの事情がありますから、当然、小国になればなんと多角外交、勢力が、貧困外交を展開したいわけです。そういう中で日本が、あるいはですね、そういったその、一つに偏った外交を展開するというのは、かなり長期的に見ていかがだろうか。中国、ロシア、そしてドイツからはるばる来てくださって、貴重な、プレゼンテーションをいただきました。